The first time I ever tested to get into a school, I was 5 years old. What was worse than failing a prestigious private school's elementary course test was the disappointed look in my mother's eye. It made me sad.
Mikako, I thought you were Miwako.
Sheesh, that's kind of insulting. But you know what? Everybody's always telling me that.
That's because you two look so alike.
What? Are you saying that I look like some teenage punk? I mean, I'm 36 years old after all. Maybe it's because of my hair color.
Is this where we'll be shooting?
That's right. This restaurant's an old western-style building that's been refurbished. Isn't it fabulous?
It looks like it's straight out of a movie set or something.
And the movie star of the day is you, Caroline.
Huh?
Everybody, can I have your attention? Our model's here.
What do you think, guys? I've got a killer eye, don't I?
I'm Yukari Hayasaka. I look forward to working with you.
To be quite honest, you had us pretty worried. I mean, Tanabechi and I busted our butts compiling that list of models for you, and you rejected every single one of them.
Sorry about that, Ikasa.
Ah, so that's the story, eh? Mikako's your usual difficult self.
It's because you constantly spoil her.
Ouch, that's harsh. Anyway, those photos of you were nice, Caroline, but you also look good in person. I'll make sure you come out looking real pretty in the ones we take today.
That's Mr. Yamaguchi, our photographer. He's the very best at what he does, and he's also Mikako's husband.
That's right. He must be Tsutomu.
Seiji, please go ahead and start on the hair and makeup.
Coming.
Your face is a little flushed. I can cover it up with makeup, but... What's the matter? Are you not feeling well?
It's nothing. I'm fine. Great, actually.
Shall we settle in and try to get you more relaxed?
It's no use. I'm too nervous. I'm gonna faint. Yukari, calm down. I have to live up to these people's expectations. Mikako's reputation's on the line.
Tell me. Why'd you decide to take this job?
Huh?
I know. Mikako threatened you, didn't she?
Cut it out, Seiji. Don't talk about me like that. I'll get a bad rap.
Ooh, I'm scared. Former outcasts sure are frightening.
Hey, shut up! You're the former outcast, Ikasa.
Oh, look. Mikako's all riled up.
Somebody should go comfort her.
Not me. That's like stepping on a landmine.
You just put your foot on it.
I did? Aw, crap!
Once I was enrolled in a public elementary school, I swore I'd redeem myself and that I would get into Tokyo's best private middle school, and I did. At around the same time, my father was transferred out of the city, and my mother used my admission into the middle school as an excuse to stay in Tokyo. But I was never going to get good grades in a school that I had to work so hard to get into, and despite my efforts, I was always below average. My mother was severely disappointed in me. The spring that I started high school, my younger brother Suguru easily made it into the elementary school I'd failed to get into. Smart and shrewdly tactful, Suguru had lived up to my mother's expectations, and my approval ratings took a nosedive. I felt like I had no value, and sadly, all I had to cling to were my studies. That I wore the uniform of a famous prep school was the one thing that just barely kept my pride intact.
You think studying for exams makes you special?
We're planning on selling them once we have a bunch.
I don't see why you have to stop. I mean, all you're doing is talking about your life, right? You shouldn't call it lame. It's important. I'll listen to whatever you have to say. You can be straight with me.
Since you're not, let's make a fabulous dress together.
Mr. Yamaguchi, your lovely model's all ready for you.
All right, then. Guess we should get started.
I wanted someone to acknowledge that I had something of value.
We handpicked you for our fashion show, so you're not going to be inferior to any of the other models out there.
That's it. Looks great. Could I have you turn a little more to the left? Keep your eyes focused here. Ooh, that's really nice.
Are you hot? Should I have them turn on the AC?
Oh, no. It's okay. I'm fine.
It's really bizarre. Ever notice how models and actresses never sweat? Why is that?
That is really strange.
Hey, Seiji. Do you think this hat would look better after all?
Either one's fine. They're both cute.
Aw, you're not even looking.
You still act like a little baby no matter what age you are.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm trying to come up with the next pose for you. Hey, don't laugh. I'm serious.
So like this then?
Perfect.
Told you.
Hey, Tanabechi. Don't you think this hat would be better? The brim's so wide on this one, we'll have to tilt it.
But the tilted look can be real cute too.
That's true. I think you may be right. It's settled then.
Mikako put so much thought into just choosing a hat, and she's the one who chose me. All of these people work so hard to put this together. It creates such a positive energy. And I'm a part of it. A part of their world.
Well, that's a wrap. Thanks for all your hard work, everybody.
Good work, everyone. Thanks.
Hey, Caroline. Hmm? You must be starving. We're all meeting for dinner downstairs. The food here is super delicious.
Thank you for the invitation. But I've already made other plans. Sorry.
Oh, yeah? Let me guess. Do you have a date with George?
No, I don't have a date.
But aren't you two all lovey-dovey? George is a really great guy, isn't he? He's so cool and kind-hearted, not to mention smart and polite, too. He's the epitome of the perfect gentleman.
You really think so? Hey, wait. Does this mean that you actually know George personally, then?
Mm-hmm. I know him because I've used him in my Happy Berry shows. It was about 2 years ago. That's when we started our men's line, and he's walked for me every season.
He's a model, too.
I know. You should walk in our next show, too.
Of course, I'd love to.
All right, then. It's decided. I'll call you later, okay? Say hi to George for me when you see him.
Nice work today.
Huh?
Are you running off to your date now?
No, it's nothing like that.
Koizumi was actually quite worried about you, you know.
What? George was?
He asked me to lend you a hand if it looked like you were gonna botch things up, but it's not like there was any need for that.
Oh, I didn't know.
Maybe I wasn't supposed to tell you he said that. Well, I have another gig, so I must be going.
Thank you for all your help today.
Yukari! It was my pleasure. I hope to work with you again.
Thanks a lot! Me too! I did it!
Excuse me?
Me?
Yes. Would you mind taking a picture with us?
Not at all.
Let me get another.
Thank you so much! I'll definitely buy the magazine when it comes out. Good luck with everything!
When I get back to the studio, a pot of warm stew will be waiting for me. I'll get to share a feast with everyone. And it'll be the best feast ever.
It's incredible, Caroline! You look so beautiful in these shots!
Oh my, you're right. They are quite fabulous.
Those pros really know what they're doing. You're like a totally different person in this picture.
They were working with the best. Right, George?
I guess. Would you mind letting me hang on to one of these Polaroids?
Huh? Yeah, I guess so. But what for?
It's not really something you can say in public.
This must have been extremely tiring for you, changing into all these different outfits.
Yeah, sure was. But it was also a whole lot of fun.
I'm happy to hear that. Let's see, today's the 21st of October.
What? But isn't the show on November 2nd? That's cutting it close. Will the dress be done?
Well, it has to be. I think it'll all work out.
How can you be so laid back all the time? Nothing seems to ever get to you.
It just seems that way because you're always so frantic.
Well, I'm sorry, but that's just the way I am, okay?
That's nothing to be sorry about.
Huh?
Quite frankly, I think that it's genuinely cute. I have to say, I did notice you were looking especially good today. I think it's because your makeup's different. Did you do that yourself?
I didn't. After the shoot, Seiji toned down the makeup for me so I could wear it out on the street.
Is it okay if I kiss you?
Yeah.
Do you think Sis and Tsutomu are back yet?
Well, we can't have sex if they're back already. This sucks. I'm going home.
Is it because I just can't help making all those loud noises?
Come on, stop being so silly.
I'm sorry, Arshi. You'll have to be okay with just a good night kiss for tonight.
Good night.
Arshi. Kiss?
Good night. I'll see you tomorrow.
Huh?
What is it? Is something wrong?
It's nothing. See you tomorrow. Would you like to come in for a cup of tea?
Well, that sure is a roundabout way to ask me in. But if you absolutely insist, I think I can stay long enough for a cup.
I don't have any tea to serve, not to the likes of you!
Okay. See you around, then.
Wait! I do have some instant coffee if you want!
All right. Sure.
Hold on. Which one was it?
The suspense is killing me.
The light switch, it's...
I have no problems with being in the dark.
Just give me a sec to boil the water.
Okay. I'll head home right after we have coffee.
home.
Oh, hey, welcome back. Hiro's here to see you.
Huh?
You know, Toki's boy, Hiroyuki.
What?
Hey, long time no see.
Yeah.
I heard that you had moved back in here with your mom for a while. So what happened? You okay?
Does it make a difference? Anyway, who the heck studies when they go to visit someone? You haven't changed.
I'm actually in the middle of exams right now, but I came over because there's something I wanted to ask you.
Yeah? Okay, so what is it?
Do you have any idea where Hayasaka is?
Thanks for the coffee. See ya.
Huh? George!
Yeah, what is it?
Well, why do I always have to be the one to do this? Don't go home! I feel like I have a one-sided crush.
Don't do that.
Crying and begging doesn't work with George. George doesn't respond to it, because he doesn't like girls who are like that. I can hear George's heartbeat. It's racing. It's in sync with mine.
You don't weigh a thing. You sure you're not missing any parts inside?
Why don't you find out for yourself?
I will.
Classmates? Really? You and Yukari?
I thought you already knew that.
I didn't. But it makes sense. You guys do go to the same school.
I talked to Miwako the other day. Didn't she say anything about it to you?
No, she didn't say a word.
I see. So anyway, do you know where Hayasaka's staying right now?
Yeah, right. Hell if I know.
I'll ask Miwako then.
Fine! Yukari's in my apartment, okay?
I figured as much. Thank you.
We're, facing the wrong way.
Don't worry about it. It's better feng shui this way.
I see.
Either way, this is unpleasant. Why do we have to do this in Arashi's bed?
So do you want to go someplace else then? Would you prefer a cemetery?
Will you please stop teasing? I can't take much more of this.
Miwako, what are you doing here?
Are you here to visit Caroline?
Mm-hmm.
You could tell me what you want to tell her. Caroline's in the middle of being kinky right now.
What are you talking about?
In the 18 years before I met George, I was an innocent girl who'd never even been kissed. I only had a vague understanding of what went on between a man and a woman in regards to love. And when it came to sex, the only thought I had was, why would you do something like that? But despite that, even though I expected to feel lost, my body responded naturally to George's fingers and to his lips. Is this what they call instinct?
Yukari. Does it really feel that good to you?
Please don't ask me questions like that. It's too embarrassing.
I want to hear you say it.
Is it just George? Or are all men this good at kissing?
I'm not in all the way. Am I hurting you?
I'm okay. Really.
I'll stop.
I'm fine. I'm crying because I'm happy.
They're not all as impressive as mine.
Oh, jeez. Why'd you have to say that? I was having a moment.
At least I made you relax.
Huh?
I'm in now.
What should I do? I'm crying for real this time. I pray that this will bring us closer together.
I see. I get the picture. She didn't feel like her mom listened to her, so that's why she finally just left.
Yeah, I'm not good at explaining sometimes, so...
It's okay. I understand. Besides, I'm used to the way you ramble when you talk.
Oh.
Hey, what was all that kinky stuff about before?
That was a mistake! Just my wild imagination.
Imagination?
Yeah, so there's really nothing to worry about. I'm sure that George is being really nice to her. I can tell these things. It's just this sense that I have. Kinda like a woman's intuition.
That wasn't exactly the kind of thing I was worried about. This is giving me a headache.
What? Your head hurts? Do you feel okay, Hiro? Maybe you're studying too hard.
I feel like this is the first normal conversation we've had in a long time.
Hiro.
That very next morning, at the crack of dawn, I decided to take my things and move into George's place. For as long as I can remember, I've stumbled through life. But if I can stay grounded when I'm near you, I think I'll be able to find paradise.
He's a friend, I'm so proud of.